welcome to Neutral Side Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Tulsa has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. Taken from the 3-yard line. Oh, he got nailed on that one. The Trojans having a wide receiver like this, I think sometimes it even helps a young quarterback, because this kid goes out there, he works hard in practice every day, and I think he really lifts the whole offense.
I think he does. I think he's almost like having an extension from the coaching staff into the locker room with the players. He's a guy that makes big plays, but I think he takes it upon himself to be able to help out with some of the other receivers, make sure that they're all on the same page, understand the route adjustments, understand everything that goes on with being a wide receiver and the importance of blocking. So all the little things that seem to add up and make big plays, I think this guy totally understands his responsibilities being a go-to player.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 41. Fires out to his receiver. Tackle at about the 49.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Quickly incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 49.
Here we go. Green 95. Green 95.
Just throws this one away.
And a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
First and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line.
Here we go.
They'll give it off here. And they make the stop right around the 22-yard line. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy. Up the middle for a nice game. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. It's the ninth play of the drive. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
That'll bring up third and eight.
Third down again. He's scrambling. Tackle made at the 15. Called his own number on that one.
I like the idea of trying to run here, but the defense really made him pay the price for trying to run.
USC is looking to go up by 3. Kicks away, and it's good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 25. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
Personal foul. Clipping. Receiving team. That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. He's tackled at the 22-yard line. Nice run up the middle.
Makes the tackle. Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. He's taken down at the 30.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
That'll make it fourth and two.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. And down he goes at the 42. Well, the defense held him to 3 on their last possession. Pitching a shutout on this drive would be even better. USC holds a field goal lead. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
And he's taken down at about the 45. Loss of 2 on the run by the halfback. Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 45-yard line. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. They'll get him for a loss.
That brings up third and 12.
They come out in a 5-wide set. Fires it out. And down he goes, right around the 38-yard line. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Dumps it out left to the running back. Down, around the 30-yard line. USC is up a field goal. And he tackles him hard at the 20. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Yet to go, but at the end of one, USC's got a 3-point lead. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play.
Here we go.
Going to the end zone, and it's coming back out. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. And he's tackled around the 33-yard line. Scrambling around. They'll bring him down around the 34-yard line. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle at the 46-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Yard pickup on the tailback on the counter play.
That brings him second and one.
And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Gets out to about the 42-yard line. From the 42-yard line, second down. It's caught, first down, and he's out of bounds.
That was a good reaction to the blitzing linebacker. That's what you like to see out of a young quarterback. He just has to ignore the pressure and get the ball out of there on time.
They'll drop him for a loss.
Anytime a running back gets one-on-one with a safety, I think that running back has the confidence in his own athletic ability to be able to make that safety miss and get upfield for some yards. That time, the safety just dominated him, made a great tackle in the backfield for a short loss.
He's going to try and scramble. He lost the ball. It's picked up.
What was most impressive is how he followed the play and he just didn't give up on it. It was that effort that allowed him to come away with the fumble.
There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. USC has a three-point lead. Pitches it, and he's hit in the backfield. From their own 17-yard line, second down. Kirk, we saw this guy head to the locker room a little bit earlier. Good to see him back on the sideline, and it looks like he could be returning to the game. He's hit and taken down. Here's the throw to the fullback. He's out of bounds around the 27-yard line. Taken down at the 40.
Brad, everywhere we go when we travel over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread or the pistol and hurry-up tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
A yard, maybe two on the carry.
Gain 2 yards. That makes it 7.
gets to about the 44-yard line. Steps out at the 46. From the 46-yard line, it's second down. Now he tries to buy some time. Room around the corner. He's wrapped up for the sack. Got it out to his tight end. And they make the stop at the 44. Trying to change the field position with his kick. Makes it to the 42-yard line. Not sure about that play call as they fail on fourth down. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. USC is up by three. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And they'll get him in the backfield. Loss of a yard.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
It's second and 11. Ball on the 41-yard line. Handoff, and he's met in the backfield. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's knocked out of bounds around the 46-yard line. This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. Gets out to about the 21. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He's out to the 30. He makes his way to about the 38. That's the end of the half, and believe it or not, folks, it's still anyone's ball game. The Trojans with a 3-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half.
The expectation coming into this game is that both offenses would do what they've pretty much done in the past. Come up with these big plays, explosive chunk plays. The defense has done a great job being able to take them away.
No, absolutely, and that's goal number one. And especially when you face an explosive offense, you know what they can do. Especially offenses like this, like you're talking about, when they hit the home run. You know, next thing you know, you look up, the guy's hit his head on the goalpost, and he just went 70-plus yards. And you really want to try to limit the damage. And that's what you've done in the first half. You've made good tackles. Sometimes you got to make a difficult open field tackle on a wide receiver that is fast and knows how to get to the end zone. But, you know, they've done enough of that in the first half to limit the damage and not give up too many big plays.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Trojans continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Gains his way to the 40-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That makes it second and six.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and two.
Check that out. This go right out. Motion, motion, motion.
And he's level at the 50.
That's a gain of two.
So they're going to go for it here. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Tackle made around the 45-yard line.
Number 16 makes the tackle at the 45-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. He gets to about the 34-yard line. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. This one's picked off. There he goes.
I really like this corner's ability to read the play. He shows very good football smarts and pretty good hands, too.
First and 10. Ball on the 45. USC holds a field goal lead. Gets to about the 47-yard line. Down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's tackled around the 49-yard line. Here's the... Nope, they snap into the upback. He's taken down at the 47. The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Come on, come on.
taken down at the 41. Caught with room to work. And he is drilled at the 35-yard line.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
He makes it to the 32-yard line. He gets to about the 24-yard line. Hit immediately. And he's taken down right around the 12-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 12. He's scrambling. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. And he hits the PAT. So a 7-play, 52-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So the score now, 7-3. And down he goes at the 18-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. The halfback with a carry. Brought down around the 21-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and 8.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. Big opening. That's a great tackle at the 30-yard line. Into that quickly. And down he goes at the 38.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Well, Kirk, we saw this kid head to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, and now we see he's back on the sideline. That's good news. Looks like he should be able to get back in the action. Tackle after a decent run up the gut, and he carried that one for a few yards.
You know, when you have a guy that can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure takes some of the pressure off the passing game.
Quarters now, and still the defenses are shining. The Golden Hurricane lead 7-3. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. They go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line. From their own 44-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled at the 48.
tackle right there. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Tackle at the 45-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. There's a strike complete. He's down. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Fires out to his receiver. So they'll get the first down there on the 5 yard completion.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump off pass that was good enough for a first down.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. Airing it out long. They bring him down at the 1 yard line. First and goal, and they need a touchdown. So they're back in the red zone where they threw a pick on their last visit. Touchdown, and now they're in front.
It takes a lot of strength to run it when you're heading into a massive pile of bodies. Good job of holding on to it and getting it across the goal line.
Trying to go up by three. They'll kick the extra point. He makes the PAT. USC to kick. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. It just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. He's going to try and scramble. And they make the stop at the 35. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Going to be sacked for a loss. Pretty obvious passing down here as they're faced with third and long. Over the middle. Tackle made right around the 34. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. Well, if you like defensive football, you got to love this one.
Now, neither one of these offenses have gotten really into a rhythm the entire ball game. Still the fourth quarter to be played. It's anybody's game.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. He's tackled at the 44.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Short over the middle. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Tulsa's going to have to use their second time out of the half. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. That's a backward pass. It's a live ball. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Quick throw. He's at the 40. He's taken down at about the 35.
That makes it first and 10.
A smart play here by the quarterback. He threw it into the window the zone coverage gave him. Nice pass and a nice job by the receiver running the slant.
Straight run, nothing going on there. Touchdown, and they take the lead. You got to think the way that offense dug deep to get the lead here this late in the fourth quarter, that might translate over and give enough emotion to their defense to win the football game. And he tacks on the extra point. Tulsa ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 37. The Trojans have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him or do they do something different?
Well, I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
He's got it with room to run, and down he goes around the 40-yard line. USC's going to take their first time out of the half. Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 40-yard line, under a minute left. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
From a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Quick pass. And he's tackled around the 16-yard line. And he stops the clock with a spike. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
I love the blitz, but the quarterback did a really good job of seeing it and reading it, and then standing tall in the pocket to find his man for the first.
They line up in the jumbo set. Tackle.
3-yard line. The spike will stop the clock.
That makes it third and goal.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 63-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
So our score, 17-14. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And now the ball is loose. He picks it up. And they tackle him at the 23. This might be it. They've got the lead, but if they add to it, they know they've got a victory. So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
They'll bring him down at the 29. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. So this is it right here. One last play and one last chance to win the game. If they can get the Hail Mary, they'll pull out the miracle win. Wants to go long and done. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. USC's team right now aware that they are a team. Hey, their star didn't shine today. Everybody else picked up the pace, though.
I think we all came in expecting to see that star player really shine. And the fact that they didn't have a great game from him and still won the football game, boy, I walk away from this game as a viewer just thinking even that much more about this team than maybe what I thought prior to the football game.